mentioned that the shirt was cut, obviously. Can you explain, if you know, why the shirt was cut?
Yeah, when we come upon shirts like this, when victims are being treated, usually these shirts are cut by EMS or first responders to render aid to the victim.
Thank you. Now, you said that you laid this out to dry.
Yes, sir.
Was it because of the blood itself?
Yes, it was wet with suspected blood stains.
Okay. Now, in preparing for trial, did you have the, did you view the shirt prior to coming here today?
The shirt was viewed prior to submission and was viewed
for trial
prep, yes.
And now, did you have the time to go through and look to see if this, how many stab wounds were in fact on the shirt?
Yeah, I observed, if I recall, I think it was three or four defects, what we call the holes that we see in the shirt. At one, two, three, collecting evidence in each of the cases, how do you keep track of everything? phase of processing the scene.
Now, did you complete evidence logs in this case?
Yes, I completed an evidence log for the outdoor scene at the convenience store. I completed a separate log for gathering the items of evidence from the suspect. I had another log which was completed for the items that were turned over to me by Bordentown County Police Department. Additionally, there was another log completed for the search of the truck.
Okay, I'm going to show you what's been earmarked as S-31 for identification purposes. Is this the log that you created with regard to this case? Ultimately, what time did you clear that scene?
I believe I approximately cleared that scene at approximately 7:15 p.m. That evening. It was Friday evening.
Thank you. No further questions,
John. Thank you. Mr. Masciocchi.
Thank you, Your Honor. Is the chart up there for the school?
Search this area here, around here, going towards these palms here.
not the picture of the crime scene on the day of the event?
Correct. It's not really sure.
And there's been previous testimony that many of these slots were filled, these parking slots were filled. Is that consistent with your record?
Yes, there was traffic going in and out. Sorry.
Okay. And when you did your search, did you look, can you describe to the jury what you, where you looked and what you looked for?
During my search of the scene, I was looking for any types of evidence, whether there was another any type of weapons or additional blood stains or clothing or anything like that in this area here.
So you're drawing a pretty wide circle, so you'd be more specific as to where you look.
Yeah, I checked in this area here, checked here. This doesn't look like where they got fuel being stored. Worked my way towards here, and then worked on to the other side here. The diesel pumps were on both sides of this building.
So if the victim is running this way,
yes, sir.
And this argument say if the victim wanted to dispose of a weapon further, would you, did you take that into account as you were conducting your search?
I checked this area here, include this area here as well, to see if I could find any type of weapon that negative results on it. So.
Now, when you're looking for, you're starting your search from here, correct?
In that general area, yes.
Did you look anything on this side?
Yes, in fact, you'll see the one picture that I showed before. I came back on this area too and documented that through photography, searching this back area as well.
And how far did this search go?
Probably from this area towards this area here, looking in.
So say you didn't look up here or down.
I think I remember going past here in this area here, and then probably stopping right around here, sir.
And in doing that, you looked under each and every truck that was parked.
To the best that I could, as you can see, these trucks are parked very close to each other.
Now, getting back to this area, when you were looking for evidence, did you look under any of the trucks that were parked in that direction?
So, upon my arrival, there was traffic going in and out, but when I started processing the scenes, they had shut down the facility, so there was no trucks going in and out at this time.
Now, with regard to going back to the, thank you, with regard to the chart, with going back to, getting back to the, when you met up with the defendant at the Bordentown Township Police Department, you indicated in your testimony that he claimed he had abrasions, I believe, on his right arm, and you indicated that you did not see any. Is that
I did not see anything that appeared to be a cut abrasion, offensive or offensive.
Now,
but I did take pictures of it, sir.
Now, when you collected evidence, you mentioned that among other items of clothing, you collected shoelaces. His shoelaces were removed from his shoes, the ones that are right there on the photograph.
Sorry, yes, they were.
Okay. And those shoelaces were also sent to the state police for examination and evaluation?
Yes, they were, sir.
And I believe you testified that there was blood on, blood stains rather, on the shoelaces, his shoelaces.
What I describe as suspected blood stains on the shoes, sir.
Okay. And those shoelaces were examined for DNA purposes, correct?
They were submitted to the lab for examination purposes, sir.
So if a lab report came back with blood of the defendants on the shoelace, what would that indicate to you?
It would indicate that the defendant...
Objection, Your Honor. This calls for speculation.
Would indicate that possibly the defendant had bled at one time or another.
Would indicate that he was injured in some fashion.
Objection.
No.
Calls for speculation.
I'll sustain that part of the question. You can restate it.
If it indicated there was his blood on the shoelaces, would that indicate there was an altercation between him and the victim, or the victim struck him?
And in my experience, sir, he owns the shoes. He owns the shoelaces too, or part of him. If there's blood on there, it might have been from a previous engagement. I did not see any injuries on the defendant while I photographed him at the police station.
Well, the defendant had braces at the time of the photograph, correct?
Yes, he did.
In fact, you asked him to smile on one of the photographs in order that you can memorialize the fact that he had braces.
Correct.
And did you indicate to him, or ask him rather, whether or not he was striking him out?
I asked him if he had any injuries. I don't recall if I asked him if he was striking him out, sir.
So then upon, when you're doing your investigation and walking around looking for the blood trail, is it shut down at that point?
Yes, it's shut down. That store area, there's still traffic going in and out of the facility, but that store itself is shut down.
I mean, we all just saw a photo counsel asked about the defendant's mouth. Did you see any injuries with regard to the defendant's mouth or the defendant's person or the defendant's anything?
No, not that I recall. And if I do see any type of injuries, I document that usually with a scale, similar to the scale that you saw at the scene. It'd be a much smaller scale, but I usually document those injuries with some type of scale.
So yeah, I'm just placing that as 44. Now, if you had seen an injury, whether it be on his arm or anywhere, would you have done anything differently?
I would have taken what I refer to as close-up pictures of it to document it. Did not see them when I made my observations of them.
In addition to your evidence logs, you had stated you wrote a report in that case?
Yes, ma'am.
And is the purpose of your report to kind of help document what you've done and refresh your recollection?
That's correct.
In addition, I believe you testified, approximately how many pictures did you take in this case?
Probably a couple hundred. Without seeing my record, probably a couple hundred pictures.
And what is the purpose of taking all of those pictures?
To document and memorialize the search of the area, and also to include views of that area from different locations.
Okay. No further questions, John.
Mr. Masciocchi?
Yes, Your Honor. Detective, with regard to crime scene itself, you indicated traffic was going back and forth until you were able to at least secure the scene to prevent further traffic.
That's correct, sir.
Well, then, would it be safe to say that while the traffic's going back and forth, the scene's being contaminated or at least interrupted with?
You could describe it as being interrupted, yes, sir.
So, in the course of it being interrupted or contaminated, the evidence may have been moved or misplaced or whatever.
As I said, upon my arrival, it was still an active area. It was closed, and during my course of the search, I was not able to locate any items of evidence with the exception of the suspected blood stains on the exterior of that facility.
That being said, you can't rule out that evidence may have been removed inadvertently or intentionally prior to your arrival.
I could not locate any evidence, sir. Additional evidence.
That doesn't answer my question, though. You can't say that evidence hasn't been removed either intentionally or inadvertently prior to your arrival.
It's possible, sir.
Now, with regard to my questioning earlier about the potential injury to my client's mouth, the incident is described to have occurred somewhere between 9:10 and 9:15 in the morning on October 12th. Is that correct?
That's my understanding, yes.
And this examination doesn't take place until much later in the afternoon.
I would say approximately probably maybe 4 in the afternoon, sir, if I remember off the top of my head, without looking at the report.
So several hours between the incident and your examination, is that correct?
Yes, sir.
And if there is a mouth injury, it may not have been apparent by that point.
It's possible.
And you prepared a miscellaneous services report. It's a typical,
yes,
form for your office in investigating crime scenes. Have you reviewed the report in preparation for your testimony today?
Yes, I have.
You recall indicating in your report,
there's a couple typos in it, so I can tell you that right now.
Yeah, I do that all the time, too. So.
Yes.
Getting back to the question, you indicated in your report that my client indicated to you that he had scratches and abrasions on his right arm.
I think in my report, I say I documented the same.
Right, and you took a photograph.
Yes.
You didn't indicate in your report that you didn't find any, but you do indicate that you took a picture.
Yes, sir.
No other questions, Detective. I'm sorry. No other questions.
Sergeant Horne, you are the justice one's complete this time.
Thanks, sir.
Thank you. Ms. Lane, if you can come up to the witness stand to my right and to your left.